important that either Bob or I went, and he couldn't go because he was doing other bits and pieces involved with Band Aid. It was important that one of us went, because if we didn't go, the cameras wouldn't go. And we knew it was of the utmost importance that those pictures and what was going on over there was still headline news. It was still a three-ring circus, basically, because that was a strength. You know, we were media people and we could keep it in the public eye and try and do something about it. So I went with the first emergency flight there was some trucks and high-protein biscuits and whatever medication. Flew over on a transporter plane and went out and arrived on the tarmac and things after a very rough night in the plane, and was greeted by a variety of people. And they took us to Addis Ababa, which gave me quite a surprise, because Addis Ababa is the capital of Ethiopia, and it's like any capital in the world. It's a city. Trains and buses, and maybe not trains, but trucks and buses, and people going to and from work, you know, like anywhere else in the world. And he took us to a Hilton hotel, air-conditioned hotel that you'd find in London or Miami or Glasgow or whatever. And there were people sitting there around the swimming pool having cocktails and lunch and things. And then they put us on a Land Rover, and we drove for 20 minutes to an aid camp, a small aid camp, which held just over 6,000 people. And it was night and day. It was just quite incredible. And it was quite a good aid camp. A lot of the people I saw there were on the mend, and they said it was a good day because only three people had died that day. And it was just the contrast, because I had expected to see what I saw in the aid camp, but I didn't expect to see people leading perfectly normal lives. It was definitely a them and us situation. It kind of annoyed me at first, thinking, well, you know, why am I doing this? You know, why are the people in Britain and Ireland sort of donating money and caring? How about this? And they don't seem to. And then I just thought about it, and I thought, well, just it's a them and us situation, just like we have a them and us situation here in Britain and or in America, and, you know, those who have and those who haven't. But it just seemed that it was the situation over there that was different, you know, the political situation, and the people who were dying were people who just weren't wanted, they weren't needed in the country, they had no use for the government, you know, served no purpose. So I think the fact that they were starving to death was probably doing them a favour, and that was, I just felt sorry for them after that. I felt it quite pathetic that a bunch of pop stars sort of started something that made. Led the way for a lot of people to get involved, and the governments were lagging way behind, because it's, you know, although the money it was raised was seemed an awful lot of money, it's a drop in the ocean. You know, we haven't got the power, and we're not in a position to generate the kind of money that is needed to make a serious difference. And that's why since then, you know, the famine's returned. We knew it would, and it probably always will, until something serious is done about it, and only governments can do that. As when we said that Band-Aid was like a stick in plaster, it is. It's a massive, massive problem. You know, $140 million might sound a lot, it's nothing, it's a drop in the ocean. Even if it had made no difference at all, it was an important thing to do, because you have to try, you know, you have to do something. You can't just sit back and let things, you know, disintegrate the way things seem to be going right now. You have to try, you have to attempt, otherwise we're not particularly good human beings. I think first and foremost Band-Aid achieved its main goal, and that was to save lives. There's no doubt that we did that. We've also set up a variety of long-term development projects, which we're analysing just now. But I think that the main thing that Band-Aid's left is a little bit of hope. The fact that, you know, a bunch of renegades can get together and do something and do it reasonably well, and leave it open for other people to do the same. And in the past, people have tried to do things like Band-Aid and Live Aid, and for a variety of reasons, they haven't happened, or they haven't generated the money or whatever. This time we showed that it could generate a lot of money and it could make a difference. What initially started as a six-month project has gone on for 5 years now, and will probably go on for another 4 or 5 years until the long-term projects are finally done with. But no, I can't say I've regretted it. I've gained from it. I think a lot of other people did.
Somebody else.